Chapter 4, Financial Markets 1. Chapter 4, Outline, Financial Markets. 4-1, The Demand for Money. 4-2, Determining the Interest Rate 1. 4-3, Determining the Interest Rate 2. 4-4, The Liquidity Trap. Appendix. The determination of the interest rate when people hold both currency and checkable deposits. Learning objectives. How is the interest rate determined in the short run? Why the answer matters. Key tools, concepts, and assumptions. Define stock and flow variables and distinguish wealth, a stock, from income, a flow variable. Understand working of monetary policy and open market operations. Learning objectives continued. Understand various terms and concepts associated with the banking system. These include currency, checkable deposits, reserves, the reserve ratio, central bank money, high-powered money, the monetary base, the federal funds market, and the federal funds rate, and the money multiplier. Learning objectives continued. Assumptions. Real GDP is given. Price level is fixed. Nominal GDP is given. Understand that since nominal GDP is given, we can look at the financial market in isolation. Financial markets. Financial markets are intimidating, but they play an essential role in the economy. In this chapter, we focus on the role of the central bank in affecting the interest rate. We learn how the interest rate on bonds is determined and the role of the central bank, Federal Reserve Bank or the Fed in the United States, in this determination. The demand for money. Suppose you only have a choice between two assets, money and bonds. Money is used for transactions, but it pays no interest. Two types of money are currency and checkable deposits. Bonds pay a positive interest rate I, but cannot be used for transactions. The holding of money and bonds depends on your level of transactions, the interest rate on bonds. You can hold bonds indirectly through money market funds or money market mutual funds. In the early 1980s, the interest rate on money market funds reached 14% per year. So people earn more interest by moving their wealth from checking accounts to these funds. Focus. Semantic traps. Money, income, and wealth. Money is what can be used to pay for transactions. Income is what you earn and it is a flow. Saving is the part of after-tax income that you do not spend and it is also a flow. Savings is the value of what you have accumulated over time. Financial wealth or wealth is the value of all your financial assets minus all your financial liabilities, and it is a stock variable. Investment is what economists refer to as the purchase of new capital goods. Financial investment is the purchase of shares or other financial assets. Equation 4.1 gives us the money demand function. Demand for money MD is equal to nominal income dollar Y, a measure of level of transactions in the economy, times a decreasing function of the interest rate I. An increase in the interest rate decreases the demand for money as people put more of their wealth into bonds. Equation 4.1 means that the demand for money increases in proportion to nominal income and depends negatively on the interest rate. The relation between the demand for money and interest rate for a given level of nominal income Y is represented by the money demand curve. Figure 4-1 depicts the demand for money function. Money demand curve MD is downward sloping. For a given level of nominal income, a lower interest rate increases the demand for money. At a given interest rate, an increase in nominal income shifts the demand for money to the right. Money demand increases proportionally. A 50% increase in nominal income increases money demand by 50%. Focus: who holds US currency? The amount of currency in circulation in 2006 was $750 billion. US households together held $170 billion in currency. US firms held another $80 billion. Foreigners abroad held $500 billion, or 66% of the total for transactions, especially in countries suffering from high inflation in the past. Determining the interest rate. 1. Suppose the central bank decides to supply an amount of money equal to M. MS equals M. Equilibrium in the financial markets requires that MS equals MD equals M. Equation 4.2 states the equilibrium condition in the financial markets, that money supply M equals money demand, given by the equation dollar Y times a decreasing function of the interest rate. Figure 4-2 illustrates the determination of the interest rate. The interest rate must be such that the supply of money, which is independent of the interest rate, is equal to the demand for money, which does depend on the interest rate. Graphically, the equilibrium interest rate is given by the intersection of the money supply curve, which is vertical, and the money demand curve, which is downward sloping. Figure 4-3 illustrates the effects of an increase in nominal income on the interest rate. Given the money supply, an increase in nominal income, shown by shift of the money demand curve to the right on the diagram, leads to an increase in the equilibrium interest rate. Adjustment mechanism to the new interest rate is through the working of the bond market. When demand for money increases at the existing interest rate, people sell bonds to hold more currency. This causes bond prices to fall and interest rate to rise. Figure 4-4 illustrates the effects of an increase in the money supply on the interest rate. An increase in the supply of money shifts the money supply curve to the right, leading to a decrease in the equilibrium interest rate. Adjustment mechanism is that as money supply increases, money demand remains less than the money supplied at the old equilibrium interest rate. This causes people to buy bonds with the money they do not wish to hold. Bond prices increase and interest rate falls. This is how monetary policy is conducted. By changing the money supply, the equilibrium interest rate can be changed to affect the aggregate demand in the economy. Conclusion: for a given money supply, an increase in nominal income leads to an increase in the interest rate. An increase in the supply of money by the central bank leads to a decrease in the interest rate. Central banks typically change the supply of money by buying or selling bonds in the bond market, called open market operations. Expansionary open market operation means the central bank expands the supply of money by buying bonds. Contractionary open market operation means the central bank contracts the supply of money by selling bonds. Figure 4-5 shows the balance sheet of the central bank and the effects of an expansionary open market operation. The assets of the central bank are the bonds it holds. The liabilities are the stock of money in the economy. An open market operation in which the central bank buys bonds and issues money increases both assets and liabilities by the same amount. Determining the interest rate. 1. You can see the inverse relation between the interest rates and the price of bond referred to earlier here. Interest rate I is equal to the amount a bond will pay in 1 year, say $100, minus the price of bond and the result divided by the price of bond. Thus, the higher the price of the bond, the lower the interest rate, and higher the interest rate, the lower the price of bond today. Example, put price of bond equal to $90 and solve for I. Now put price of bond equal to $95 and solve for I. You will see that higher price of bond will give us a lower value for I. Rather than the money supply, the central bank could have chosen the interest rate and then adjusted the money supply so as to achieve the interest rate it had chosen. Choosing the interest rate instead of the money supply is what modern central banks, including the Fed, typically do. determining the interest rate too. Financial intermediaries, institutions that receive funds from people and firms and use these funds to buy financial assets or to make loans to other people and firms. Banks are financial intermediaries that have money in the form of checkable deposits as their liabilities. Banks keep as reserves some of the funds they receive. The liabilities of the central bank are the money it has issued, called central bank money. Figure 4-6 shows the balance sheet of the central bank and commercial banks, financial intermediaries. The main asset of the central bank is the same as before, bonds. The liabilities now consist of central bank money, which is made up of currency, in circulation in the hands of the public, and reserves, currency in the vaults of the commercial and central banks. The main assets of the commercial banks are reserves, loans, and bonds. Their liabilities are the checkable deposits. Equation 4.3 is the money demand function. Assume people hold no currency, so the demand for money by people is the demand for checkable deposits. Equation 4.4 tells us that the demand for reserves by banks depends on the amount of checkable deposits, since banks are required by law to hold a certain fraction, theta, of the checkable deposits in the form of reserves. Theta is the reserve ratio, and HD is the demand for high-powered money, or the monetary base, or central bank money. Let H denote the supply of central bank money. Then equation 4.5, H equals HD, gives us the equilibrium condition in financial markets in terms of demand and supply of central bank money. Equation 4.6 substitutes the demand for central bank money calculated in equation 4.4 to show how equilibrium interest rate is determined in the financial markets by equating the demand and supply of central bank money or the monetary base. Once again, this allows you to see how monetary policy is used to influence the interest rate and hence aggregate demand in the economy. H is determined by the central bank. An increase in H leads to a decrease in the interest rate, and a decrease in H leads to an increase in the interest rate. Figure 4-8 illustrates graphically equilibrium in the market for central bank money and the determination of the interest rate. The equilibrium interest rate is such that the supply of central bank money is equal to the demand for central bank money. The supply of central bank money curve is vertical, since it is independent of the interest rate. The central bank money demand curve is downward sloping. The intersection of the two curves gives the equilibrium interest rate. The interest rate that the central bank influences directly is the federal funds rate. All the short-term interest rates in the economy depend on the federal funds rate. The federal funds market is an actual market for bank reserves. The federal funds rate is the interest rate determined in the federal funds market. The federal funds rate is the main indicator of U.S. monetary policy because the Fed can choose the federal funds rate it wants by changing H. The liquidity trap. Zero lower bound refers to the condition that nominal interest rate cannot go below zero. The economy is in a liquidity trap when the interest rate is down to zero, since monetary policy cannot decrease it further. Figure 4-8 illustrates the liquidity trap. Once interest rate is down to zero, as money supply is increased and money supply curve intersects money demand curve at point B, beyond that point, as money supply curve shifts further to the right, equilibrium interest rate stays at zero at point C. So what is happening? When the interest rate is equal to zero, and once people have enough money for transaction purposes, they become indifferent between holding money and holding bonds. The demand for money becomes horizontal. This implies that when the interest rate is equal to zero, further increases in the money supply have no effect on the interest rate, which remains equal to zero. Figure 1 shows that when interest rates hit zero at the end of 2007, all the increase in central bank money shown by the red curve were matched by increase in demand for money, checkable deposits, leaving interest rates at zero from 2007 to 2014. Appendix: the determination of interest rate when people hold both currency and checkable deposits. Equation 4.A1 gives the overall money demand when people hold both currency and checkable deposits. Equation 4.82 gives the demand for currency equation, and equation 4.83 gives the demand for checkable deposits equation on the assumption that people hold a fixed proportion of their money, C, in the form of currency, and 1 minus C in checkable deposits. Figure 4-A1 shows the determinants of the demand and supply of central bank money and thus the interest rate when people hold both currency and checkable deposits. Equation 4.A4 shows that reserves are a constant fraction theta of checkable deposits D. Equation 4.A5 shows the reserve function after substituting 4.A2 in 4.A4. Equation 4.A6 gives the demand for high-powered money or central bank money or monetary base as the sum of the demand for currency and reserves. Equation 8.47 gives the final version of the demand for high-powered money function. You can see all the variables that demand for high-powered money depends on. Equation 4.A8 and 4.A9 give us the equilibrium condition for the determination of interest rate when people hold both currency and checkable deposits. The equilibrium condition is that the supply of central bank money be equal to the demand for central bank money.